my best to keep my attention out here because I'm a ardent friend of cricket, so I'm sure you guys will be facing the same. Thanks for joining in this session. My name is Zahir. I've got this opportunity to drive this large change management initiative within Wipro along with Ritu. I've got my colleague Ritu here. So in next 35 to 40 minutes, what we plan to do is we plan to share our experience on this huge agile change management initiative, more from a service company perspective, and the journey that we had gone through. So that's a quick update of ourselves. So we started our journey in 2005, 2006 timeframe, where the core contention was to streamline the Scrum and the XP processes, pilot some of the projects in Agile using those practices with some flavor of distributed Agile. So that's the start, that was the very humble beginning that we had. But as we started partnering with some of our customers in this huge Agile transformation, we realized that it was a huge disruption in our ecosystem. What we realized was that while the teams were enjoying the Agile execution on the ground, they were having the appreciation of the way Agile was executed. The problem started when there was a conflict of interest in what they were doing on the ground level and what was the charter or the goals and objectives that was defined in the system for them. So that was the first conflict of interest that we found. Basically, the systems were, and the goals and objectives were derived to bring in the individual excellence. And as the teams were maturing, it was more about the collaborative approach, and that's where the first HR disruption started for us. The next step was in terms of, as the team started gaining maturity in Agile, they became more self-organized on the ground level. And with the large transformation, the team started challenging some of the rules. The team started challenging the existence of some of the rules. So it became very imperative for us on how do we go about absorbing those roles that we have been having for more than 15, 20 years now. And at the same time, with those roles being challenged, what happened was, we typically, from a service company perspective, coming from a pyramid structure, wherein there was a top-down approach, suddenly we started thinking, how do we move into a flat structure and probably into a hourglass structure, as we call it in Wipro. So those were the challenges that we started facing. Other thing was, we had our own pockets of excellence, wherein we had engagements where we were completely mature in Agile. We are excellent in driving Agile. The teams were empowered. The teams had got their surround structure to get the collaboration that was required at the team level, the kind of infrastructure that required at the team level. The problem we faced there was, how do we broad-base that across the organization? So when we're talking about broad-basing the organization, it was about 100,000 people that we're talking about.